Hello everyone, a very warm welcome again to the virtual session of Science Children. I hope you all are doing very well. So let us see what are we going to have in this virtual session today. We are going to continue with the chapter Getting to Know Plants, part 6. So let us see what are we going to learn in this session. We are going to do NCRT exercise, that is your textual exercise, and as the regular practice, you all know you have to write these question answers in your notebook. So let us get started. We are going to start with the NCRT exercise, and I hope you all are maintaining your notebook, children. So please enter all the question answers of the textual exercise in your notebook. Exercise questions here. Correct the following statements and rewrite them in your notebook. You have to correct the statement, because this statement somewhere, some concept is wrong or incorrect. So you have to correct them and you have to rewrite them in your notebook. First one, stem absorbs water and minerals from the soil. So you all know you have learned all the concept based on this chapter. Almost all the concept we had covered. So you know the correct answer. You need to correct the statement. So the correct statement, roots absorb water and minerals from the soil. This is the correct statement. I hope you all got the correct statement. Then the next one, leaves hold the plant upright. So what should be the correct statement over here? You all know, stem holds the plant upright. The third one, roots conduct water to the leaves. So let us see the correct statement for this. Stem conduct water to the leaves. As you all know, we have learned all this concept. So stems conduct water to the leaves. That is the role of the stems. Then the number of petals and stamens in a flower is always equal. So let us see. The number of petals and stamens in a flower may not be always equal. It may vary. It may be different. So it will not be the same all the time. The number of petals and stamen in a flower may not be always equal. Then next one, if the sepals of a flower are joined together, its petals are also joined together. So let us see the correct statement. If the sepals of a flower are joined together, its petals are separate. This is the correct statement. Please do write all this in your notebook, children. Then if the petals of a flower are joined together, then the pistil is joined to the petal. So what should be the correct answer? You'll have learned all this in the previous session. So let us see. If the petals of a flower are joined together, then the pistil may or may not be joined to the petal. So it is not necessarily that the pistil will be joined to the petal. It may or may not be joined to the petal. So this is the solution for all the incorrect statement, and you have to write all the correct statement, children. I hope this is very clear with you all. So let us see the next question here. Draw a leaf, a tap root, then a flower. You have studied for table 7.3 of the textbook. So let us see. You can do the drawing very easily. You have to draw all this in your notebook. A leaf. You have to draw this leaf. You have to show all the various parts. Label the parts with a black ballpoint pen. It will look very neat. You have to show all the parts, petiole, leaf blade, veins, lamina and midrib. Please show all these various parts of the leaf, children. And I hope you will be able to draw this diagram very neatly in your notebook. Then, taproot. As you all know, taproot will have one main root and all the small secondary roots, those are small lateral roots, will be attached to it. So the taproot will have one thick root and all these small root, fine roots, those are called lateral roots. So this is the diagram for the taproot, and you have to show this diagram along with the labeling very neatly. Please draw this in your notebook. You will show the taproot and you will show the upper part of the root. You have leaf and then you see some stem, some part of the stem, and below that, under the soil, you will have the taproot, the main root, the thick root, and the fine delicate roots, the fibers you can see, those are called lateral roots. Please draw all these in your notebook, children, and please put labeling properly. Then you have flower. You have to draw this flower and show the different parts of the flower. You will show petal, you will show stamen, pistil and sepal. I hope this is clear, children. You'll have already drawn this flower in the Zoom session. So you can, if it is not clear to you, you can refer to the diagram done in the Zoom session, children. Structure of the flower we have already covered. So you can take the diagram from there. You can show various parts of the flower. Very simple. Then question number 3, can you find a plant in your house or in a neighborhood which has a long but a weak stem? Write its name and which category would you classify it? So yes, we find a money plant in our house and it is a climber. You know, a climber need a support and it is mostly grown at the door for beautification and it takes the help or support of the door and then it grows and it gives beautification. So yes, we find a money plant in our house and it is a climber because, as the name suggests, the plants climb with the help of a support. Question number 4, what is the function of a stem in a plant? So we have learned all the function of each and every parts of the plant. We have learned the function of the roots, of the stem, of the leaves. We have learned the structure of the flower and the various parts of the leaf. We have seen and we also seen the structure of the flower and the various parts of the flower we have seen. We have seen the function of each and every part of the flower. So let us see the function of the stem. You have learned all this. A stem performs following functions. The stem and its branches holds leaves to get maximum sunlight. Next, it transports water from roots to different parts of the plant. Next, it transports food from leaves to different parts of the plant. And it bears leaves, flowers and fruits. So these are the main distinct function in the exam. Please don't overlap points or do not repeat points. These are the distinct function. Each and every function is different and these are the main 4 function of the stem. Please do write and learn this properly, children. Very important. Then question number 5, which of the following leaves have reticulate venation? So you have learned the relation between the venation and the types of the roots. So here you will come to know by looking at the leaves of the plants, which one will have reticulate venation. So here you will have wheat, tulsi, maize, grass, coriander, that is dhania, and China rose. So the answer over here, you see the reticulate venation, you check the leaves, and the reticulate venation is actually the network of the veins you can see in the leaves. That will be a reticulate venation. If the veins run parallel, then it is parallel venation. So just by looking at the leaves of these plants, you can make out what type of venation they have. So tulsi and China rose shows network of the veins in the leaves and you can easily make out that these leaves have reticulate venation because you can see the network of the venation in the leaves. And when the veins run parallel, then that is called as parallel venation. I hope this is very clear. If a plant has fibrous root, what type of venation are its leaves likely to have? So as I told you, we have learned about the relation between the fibrous root and the tap root and the type of venation they show. So fibrous roots, where they do not have main root or the thick root, all are fine roots and they are more or less equal. So you have learned about this. Fibrous roots will always show, the leaves will always show parallel venation. And the tap root will always, the plants will always show, the leaves of the plant will always show, the tap root will always show reticulate venation. So here they had mentioned if a plant has a fibrous roots, so fibrous roots parallel venation. That means if you see the leaves with parallel venation, you can easily make out that the roots will be fibrous roots. You need not uproot the plant because the parallel venation will indicate the roots are fibrous in nature. That means they do not have one main root or the thick root like the tap root. All are fibrous in nature, more or less they are equal in size. So fibrous roots, parallel venation, tap root, reticulate venation. That way you should remember. Fibrous roots, parallel venation, and tap root, reticulate venation. I hope I repeated myself. Question number 7. If a plant has leaves with reticulate venation, what kind of root it will have? Just now I told you reticulate venation, tap root. A tap root, that means it will have a thick root and fine roots, that are lateral roots attached to it. Very simple. Question number 8. Is it possible for you to recognize the leaves without seeing them? How? We cannot exactly recognize the leaves without seeing them. We may be able to have some idea by touching and smelling them. So you have to actually see the leaves to identify the leaves. You can only get some idea by touching and you will get some smell. Question number 9. Write the names of the parts of a flower in sequence from outside to inside. So the names of various parts of a flower from outside to inside are, you have learned the various structure of a flower and it has various parts. So they are sepals, petals, stamens and pistil. These are the four major parts of a flower. This is very simple. I hope it's clear, children. Question number 10. Which of the following plants have you seen? Of those that you have seen, which one have flowers? So here you have grass, maize, wheat, chili, tomato, tulsi, peepal, sisam, banyan, mango, jamun, guava, pomegranate, papaya, banana, lemon, sugarcane, potato and groundnut. So out of all these, which of the following plants have you seen, and of those that you have seen, which one have flowers? So let us see which one will have flowers. You must have seen so many types of plants, children, and you must have seen different types of flowers, and you should be able to identify them. So let us see. Just make the table and you have to list the plant as shown here in the screen. Make this table name of the plant. You put name of all the plants which is given in the question and whether seen. Yes, we normally see all this, and you have to put yes. And then whether have flowers. So they all have flowers because they flowers plays a very important role in reproduction, and that's how the plants will reproduce and it will increase in number. So plants are the reproductive part. For reproductive parts of the plants are flowers. So flowers should be present in the plant so that the plants reproduce and they will grow in numbers. I hope so. It's very clear. So that's why here every part, every plant over here mentioned in the question here, whether have flowers. So every plants over here will have flower because flower is the reproductive part of a plant, and it has to be present for the reproduction, for the growth, to increase in number. So please write down this table and put yes everywhere, because these are all very essential for the plant. Flowers are very essential, and whether seen, so most of it you must have seen, and please put yes whether seen. Name the part of the plant which produces its food. Name this process. So you all know which part of the plant do photosynthesis, that is leaves. And leaves produce food for the plant, and this process is called photosynthesis. You have learned the entire process of photosynthesis, how leaves prepare food for the plant, and this is the main part of the plant where the leaves will prepare food with the help of sunlight, carbon dioxide, chlorophyll is present in the leaf, water is required, all that requirement is fulfilled by the nature, and the leaves prepare the food and then it is transported to the various parts of the plant. So I hope this question number 11 is clear. Question number 12, in which part of a flower you are likely to find the ovary? You have learned about the ovary and you know which part of a flower you see ovary. So we find ovary in pistil, that is the female reproductive part of the flower. As you all know, a flower will have male and female reproductive part. So pistil, here if we find ovary in the pistil, and it is the lowermost part of the pistil. So ovary is also a reproductive part, and we find ovary in pistil. Name two flowers, each with joined and separate sepals. So you can name any two flowers where you see with joined and separate sepals. So flowers with joined sepals, you see Datura. Flowers where they have joined sepals and Loki, you see they have a joined sepals. Where flowers with separate sepals, you have Gurhal and Mustard. So these are the plants with the joined and the separate sepals, children. So here we come to end of the session, and I hope you all are writing in your notebook. Please take down all the question answers in your notebook, children. And very much hopeful you all are keeping your notebook updated. Thank you, children, and have a great day.